Hey glam fam, welcome back. Today is going to be Candy's best blow-ups. This is part three. This is really part two, but this is the third part of this that I've done. Let's get into it.
Your house is beautiful, by the way.
Thank you. I'm glad you guys finally came over.
Yeah.
It's gorgeous. I love it.
So did you miss us while we were gone?
I did. Troy went to camp and y'all left me. Went to South Africa. I mean, yeah, I was by myself. Did y'all have fun in Africa?
I had a great time. I really did.
I like the safaris.
Oh, the safari was awesome.
What did you say, Candy, about me in an orphanage?
Why you like that? You said it.
No, because that was some straight bull the way you brought it back to her.
Candy, are you serious?
Yes, I'm dead serious. Let me explain to her what happened. Cynthia just so happened to be stuck with us that day. She started this conversation about,
Sheree is
well,
so
I don't think
nasty.
Kim.
You said that you guys started in, oh, I don't think Kim would go to an orphanage.
No, don't say you guys.
Cynthia said that.
Listen, for real, Sheree, what are you trying to prove right now? And why are you, Kim, believing anything that Sheree has to say without even considering that she may not be telling you the correct story? The thing is, Cynthia, when she brought up your name or whatever, she said, well, I don't even think Kim would come to an orphanage, da 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 da.
She don't know me from a hole in the f***ing wall.
So she's just, you know, said her opinions and her feelings or whatever. And then I said, well, you know what? I have to agree. I don't think that Kim would do any of this. You agree with her? I don't feel like you would have came to Africa, period.
And that's what I said.
Why not?
Me,
no, that's not what you said.
Why not?
When she got you, you got her on the phone. You first started the conversation off saying to her, Candy said she didn't see you holding little black babies.
Okay, well, Candy, you've always said that like five different times. You agree with Cynthia's
letter. You didn't even mention Cynthia. It was like you just made it seem like I brought
Kim
up. It was like, Candy said she was like babies.
Why was Sheree going so hard for Kim? I don't get it.
South Africa. You don't think I would have went to South Africa?
Not with Nene and the rest of them?
Well,
no.
Sheree and Nene don't get along. She did just fine. Like, I don't get that.
I ain't talking about Sheree. I'm talking about you.
Yeah, I do it all the time. She goes to an event. I'm at an event. She's over here. I'm over here.
But I feel like you would have came up with any excuse not to go.
I've had no help with my kids whatsoever. Croy's in f***ing camp and gone for a month, Candy. I moved into a new f***ing house the week after I had the baby. You bet your ass I'm at home. My family comes first. So if I didn't have a newborn son, I would have taken my f***ing kids come hell or high water, but I would have been.
Well, what can I say to that?
I just don't think you would want to go.
Okay. Well, what's the argument about? You said it.
You don't understand.
No, you don't understand.
We can just agree to disagree.
At this point, I feel like it's no point in even going back and forth with Sheree. I really hate that the whole legacy of us going to the orphanage had to be this petty argument. She took something that was special and made it crazy.
No offense to you, but you always make up an excuse not to go some damn where. And you'll be like, oh, it's too many people. I gotta get your terms. I'll bring it back home.
But I worked hospice. I worked in the NICU. I've worked at
when the last time.
What does that have to do with anything, Kim?
It doesn't fucking matter. That's my person. That's what means the character. I put years into college and chose nursing as a profession.
Okay, but if people change, people change.
This is what I don't get with Candy. You have all of this patience with Kim. But, like, the one time Nene do something, it's nope, Nene, nope, she's this, she's that, she thinks she's better than everybody. Kim thought she was better than everybody. I just really don't get why she chose Kim over Nene. Kim thought she was better than people, too.
We are back at the Georgian Ballroom at the Biltmore Hotel with the Real Housewives of Atlanta. Candy, how did you feel about Marlo calling you a sugar mama?
I thought it was funny.
You thought it was funny?
Yes, I did. I really wasn't bothered by that comment. I was more irritated because as we were arguing, she kept saying, yeah, you said something about her being popular, da da da. And I know I was saying things about, you know, how she got her money or whatever, but I didn't never say the words big popular. I felt like she was doing that to egg up the drama between me and Kim. So that's why I was getting irritated. I wasn't as much irritated about the sugar because I'm like, really, I'm too cheap to do that, for real.
So the guy you're dating now, does he work? That used to work for production here?
Yes, he does work.
Does he go with you and drive your car?
Let me tell you, she had no clue. Let me tell you,
you're getting upset now. You changed your
car. No, 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 he don't know what the f*** is talking about.
You got upset. You're a lady. Don't talk like that.
He has a Range Rover.
Okay, well, calm down.
And if
she wants
to, we switch up and he wants to
get your posture back right.
Okay, help me
really understand. What do you mean? Why did you say that he had his way of swerving?
He had his, you know, Ty was always on the, he was always on the come up, and I'm not mad at that.
But you already know that when people say on the come up, you know that means you're getting with someone who has more money.
But all I'm saying is he always found himself in a better situation.
Natalie, don't water it down.
Honestly, you seem sweet, but you're doing the same thing to Candy that she just did to you. That's her fiancé. And you're calling out her fiancé in a way
about cheating on her.
Regardless of whatever you said or how you meant it, that's how everybody took it.
That wasn't what was said at all. That was just the past.
You trying me right now. You trying me. I don't know you, lady. Whatever you talking about is from over a decade ago.
But Mama Joy still be saying
the
same thing.
She's on the other side of the table.
No offense to you. Nobody really cares about your friend. And you can stop bringing her up. Because we really don't give a f*** about it. And bottom line for you to say that he want to date up, you just let me know you think I'm a hot bitch. And I am. And it's all good. And the buck stops here. Because it don't get no hotter. You're right. You're right. I'm successful. I can't help it. And I look good. So that means he has no reason to cheat. He got the hottest bitch in the world.
Look at Phaedra and Didi.
Oh. Nice things about you. We'll be done. We'll be done. And I'm going to leave it at that.
Thank you for coming.
I like the way Candy handled that. That was pretty funny. But why does she get mad when people call Todd an opportunist, when her own mom calls Todd an opportunist? And she still says it to this day. But yeah, those are my thoughts on that. Y'all let me know what y'all thought about that in the comment section down below. Stay happy, healthy, and all of that good stuff. And I will see y'all in my next video. Bye.